Hello friends, this is Talpat Sonagra. In this lecture, we discuss why we have a need of Turing machine. For that, we look these three languages. Of course, you know, Elven is a regular language and it is also a context-free language and L2 is not regular language and it is context-free language. This is CFG. And of course, we know that for this language L1, we construct a finite automata and pushdown automata both. In case of pushdown automata, there is no need to push or pop, means there is no use of stack, because for the language L1 there is no need of holding any input, okay, because there is no any matching and counting requirement. We just start from the state and accepting all nulls at only one state, because n language L1 is described n occurrence of a, where a is greater than equals to 1. So by using this one state, okay, like this, and this is a final state, okay, by using this we can construct a push down automata. Okay, so there is no need of pushing anything over the stack. So I think it is clear. And of course, a finite automata is only this, okay, for the language L1. Okay, I think it is clear for L1. Okay, so now look at language L2. For this L2, we does not derive or design a finite automata, because this is not a regular language, okay, because you also note that there is a counting, because the equal number of A and equal number of B means equal number of A is followed by equal number of B, so there are counting, and for the counting purpose we required a finite automata plus stack. Okay, so it is not possible to construct a finite automata for a language L2, whereas we can design a push down automata for this PDA for this L2. Okay, this is clear. So I recall, just L1 is your regular grammar, your regular language. This is also context-free language. Okay. Here we use interchangeably these words, grammar and language, because both are accepted by the corresponding automatas. The regular grammar and language accepted by finite automata, and context-free grammar and context-free language are accepted by pushdown automata. So L1 is regular grammar or regular language, context-free grammar, context-free language, and for it we can design both finite automata and pushdown automata. Now look for L2. L2 is not regular grammar or language, so it is not possible to construct a finite automata for L2, whereas we can construct a push down automata for L2, because this is a context free grammar, or you can say language. Okay, I think this is clear. Now look at the language L3. This L3, neither it is a regular language nor a context free language, therefore it is very clear we cannot construct finite automata for it and push down automata for it. First we look why, and of course it is clear we can we not construct a finite automata for a L3 because there is a counting and matchings are not possible in any of finite automata. Okay, when the matching and counting of two things or more than one things if you require, then we cannot design a finite automata, because a finite automata having only finite memory, therefore. Okay, so in L3 we required to compare three things: what, the equal number of A's, equal number of B's and equal number of C's. Okay, like string x1 and x2, in which all the occurrence of A's and B's are equal. Okay, like this and like this. And one more thing, the A should be followed by B and further it is followed by C. This is also restriction over the language L3. So if we want to construct a pushdown automata, then it is not possible, because of we can hold only one thing. So, suppose whenever we encountered A, we pushed A into the stack. Okay, like this, A, and A. Okay, and this is Z0. Once a B is encountered, okay, suppose these are the processed and we pushed these into a stack. Whenever the B is encountered at the tape, then the corresponding topmost element is popped out. Okay, so after processing 1B, one top A is popped out. After processing 2B, second top element is pop out, and for the 3B, this A is pop out. But when we reach to C, means whenever we encountered C over the input tape, then how we can count the equal the number of C, means how we check the C number of C or occurrence of C is equal to the occurrence of A and B. Therefore, it is not possible to construct a pushdown automata for a language 3. Okay, hope it is clear. One more solution is given for the L3 by using two stack. Okay, by using two stack, we can construct a machine that is also an automata, and that automata is known as two stack automata. But that is not a pushdown automata. But because pushdown automata is only a combination of finite automata and one stack. Okay, if we are using two stack, then that is not the equivalent computing power with corresponding to single stack. That machine is pushdown automata. Okay, so we come to the solution with two stack. In this case, whenever A is encountered, we push them into the stack 1. Okay, like this. Okay, and if the B is encountered, then we push those into a next stack. Okay, like this. And whenever C is encountered, okay, whenever C is encountered, then we check the top of both stack. Okay, if those are A at the stack one, and B at stack 2, then of course, then we pop out both A and B and process this single C. And similarly for the second C, if the top element of the stack 1 is A and the top element of the stack 2 is B, then we pop both and process this second C. Similarly for the third C. Okay, so like this we can perform compute an automata for language 3 by using two stack. And I repeat again, this is not a computing machine equivalent to pushdown automata, because two stack automata is totally different. Okay, and two stack automata is not accepted a particular type of grammar. Therefore, we not use that as a generalized machine or automata into a theory of computation. Okay. I hope you understand this. So, what we can do for this language L3. Okay. So, we have a need of a machine or an automata that is computing any computable function like this. Okay. Like L3, in which whenever this sequence is written, okay, so we solve this by comparing 1A and 1B and C. I repeat again, suppose for L3, a logic is we compare single first A, okay, and first B and first C. Okay, and make them clear from this string. Okay, after that again we check a second A, second B and second C. If all these three find out, then we also process them. Okay, like this we cancel one by one. Okay, if this canceling process is continue, it means this string is accepted. So for this we can design a machine like an Turing machine in which all these input symbol is written, and by moving read write head we can replace corresponding A, B and C by default symbol blank. Again we go for next, and like this if all the things are according to a language 3, then it work completely and reach to a accepting state. But one of them like A, B or C is either less or greater than to other, then the processing of this type then the processing does not lead to an accepting state in a Turing machine. Okay, so like this student, we can design the Turing machine for a language L3. Also, a Turing machine is a machine that has a capability to compute any computable function available in this world. Okay, and therefore it is also known as a general purpose computing machine. So this language is context sensitive language. Okay, this is a context sensitive language, and you can say a context sensitive grammar, but it is a language and corresponding grammar of it is known as context sensitive grammar. So for the context sensitive grammar we can construct a Turing machine, and because of context sensitive language we are not able to construct pushdown automata, so we have a need of one another computing automata that is Turing machine that can accept this context sensitive language. One more thing should be noted here, always context sensitive language is accepted by linear bound automata also. Context sensitive language also accepted by linear bound automata. This is also a new category of automata. Of course, we will discuss this linear bound automata into our upcoming lectures. And but for any language which are computed, we can construct a Turing machine for that. Okay, and Turing machine accept a recursive enumerable language. Okay, that is accepted by Turing machine, and this recursive enumerable language also known as unrestricted language. So unrestricted language is accepted by Turing machine. Okay, therefore we can construct a Turing machine for all of these languages. Okay, Turing machine. And of course we can construct a linear bound automata for all of these three languages. Linear bound automata. Okay, one more thing that should be discussed here, that regular language is a subset of context free language, and that is also a subset of context sensitive language, that is a subset of recursive enumerable language. Also, we discuss this context sensitive language and recursive enumerable language in our upcoming lecture, but this restriction is very important. Means every regular grammar or a language is a subset of a context free language. Every context free language or a grammar is a subset of context sensitive language or a grammar. Every context sensitive language is a subset of recursive enumerable language. Okay, so for a regular language we have a finite automata. Okay, so if the language is regular, then we can construct a finite automata. And context free language we accepted by push down automata. Okay, so if a language is regular or a context free language, then we can construct a push down automata for it. Okay, if a language is regular or a context free language, then we can construct a push down automata for it. And context sensitive language is accepted by linear bound automata. Okay, linear bound automata. So we can, if our language is regular and context free language or context sensitive language, then we can construct all of these by linear bound automata. And recursive enumerable language is accepted by Turing machine. So if we have a regular language, context free language, context sensitive language, for and recursive enumerable language, then for all of them we can construct a Turing machine. Okay, hope this is clear. So therefore conclusion is this: for L3 it is not possible to construct push down automata, because push down automata having some limitation for storing intermediate result. Therefore for L3 we does not construct a finite automata. So we required an automata like Turing machine that is useful for constructing this type of language. Hope you understand all these things. Thank you very much for listening.